Naturally. I thought America would declare herself against the Belgian outrage, that she would not tolerate the smashing of the great sister republic, if only for the memory of Lafayette. Well, I gather America is chiefly concerned about our making cotton contraband. I thought the Balkan states were capable of a reasonable give and take, of a common care for their common freedom. I see now three German royalties trading in peasants and no men in their lands to gainsay them. I saw this war, as so many Frenchmen have seen it, as something that might legitimately command a splendid enthusiasm of indignation. It was all a dream, the dream of a prosperous, comfortable man who had never come to the cutting edge of life. Everywhere cunning, everywhere small feuds and hatreds, distrusts, dishonesties, timidities, feebleness of purpose, dwarfish imaginations swarm over the great and simple issues. It is a war now like any other of the mobbing, many-aimed cataclysms that have shattered empires and devastated the world. It is a war without point, a war that has lost its soul. It has become mere incoherent fighting and destruction, a demonstration in vast and tragic forms of the stupidity and ineffectiveness of our species. He stopped, and there was a little interval of silence. Captain Carmine tossed the fag end of his cigar very neatly into a tub of hydrangeas. 3,000 years ago in China, he said, there were men as sad as we are for the same cause. 3,000 years ahead, perhaps, said Mr. Britling, there will still be men with the same sadness. And yet, no, just now I have no elasticity.